सो
ओके
गुड आफ्टरनून एवरीवन, रिस्पेक्टेड प्रिंसिपल
आफ्टरनून
सर डॉक्टर आर एस झुंझारा सर, वाइस प्रिंसिपल सर डॉक्टर आलंदीकर सर, आर रिसोर्स पर्सन फॉर टुडे एफडीपी डॉक्टर शांतश्री सेन गुप्ता मैडम, ऑल द एचओडीज एंड माय डियर फैकल्टीज, आई एक्सटेंड अ वॉर्म वेलकम टू ऑल ऑफ यू फॉर दिस एफडीपी on Creative Commons license for open educational resources. This FDP is basically organized for e-licensing e-contents developed by our teachers. And also, in just now we had an HOD's meeting, sir has also highlighted the importance of institutional repository. This year, we have all learned how to develop e-content and deliver them to the students effectively. But the most important part is to license the e-content so that nobody claims the efforts in other name. So in order to protect our e-content, our librarian madam has suggested and conducted a meeting on similar grounds in last month, that is on August 7th. But not all of us could attend the session. So I requested ma'am if she could kindly guide our faculties once again, and ma'am willingly agreed it to conduct a session separately for us. So without wasting much time, I would request our vice principal sir to kindly address our teachers on the same.
Good afternoon to all of you. Am I audible to you?
Yes, sir. Yes, sir.
Good afternoon to all of you. At the outset, I would like to welcome all the participants in today's faculty development program, which is based on e-content. In today's pandemic situation, e-content, e-learning, or e-communication become an integral part of our life. And we don't know to what extent we have to go through this way. No doubt, by conducting the various faculty development program online education, now we are well aware about the teaching learning process, online teaching learning process. Various apps are available, and day by day, technologically also, we are creating the awareness. The subject which relating to the practicals, like accounts, like taxation, now with the support of a camera, we can use the blackboards. Normal lectures, we can, online lectures, we can easily conducting through now the Google Meet. So now we are quite familiar with these sources, even though our all the computer practicals are also conducted by computer faculty. So almost all the academic activities we are doing online basis by creating the e-content. But more than that, even the curricular and co-curricular activity, the FDP or the administrative activities also we are conducting through this. Because there is no any option than the social distancing, we could not gather even in our campus. Though the strength is around 80, we cannot gather at a time. And therefore, we are using this online system, online mode. Now, e-content become an essential part of our education system. And I am very happy our librarian, Dr. Sen Gupta Madam, took an initiative regarding this particular subject. The subject relating that the creating the common license open for educational resources. This is a quite an innovative subject, or it's a need of present time. No doubt, this will support us for a long time, and it will be there for value addition. No doubt, we have to follow the things. We have to follow the change, because change is the rule of nature. We have to adjust with the situation. And we don't know up to what extent this kind of the pandemic situation will be there. So considering the present need of time and considering the expectation, of our particular academic area, the faculty, through the faculty development program, we have to develop ourselves. No doubt some technological challenges are there, some connectivity challenges are there, but with the support of our management and with the support of under the guiding direction of our honorable chairman, as compared to the other institutes, we are doing a lot of things through the online mode. No doubt this is possible because of your preparation. Since the month of May, we are involving in this e-content preparation process. Now we are, I think through this session, we are going one step ahead, and no doubt this step will be support us in due course. So once again, I would like to thank Professor Sengupta, Dr. Sengupta, Madam Librarian, Modern College, for her initiative. Then Dr. Fernandez, HOD of Commerce of our Business Administration Campus, Professor Patil sir, and all HODs. Once again, I would like to welcome you and thanks to you for your initiative. Once again, I would like to welcome you, all the participants from our campus. Thank you very much.
Thank you very much, sir. Now I request our principal, sir, to kindly guide our faculty.
In this particular session, we have Dr. M.D. Alandikar, Vice Principal of Business Administration Campus of our college. Resource person in today's session, our librarian, Dr. Shanta Sri Sengupta. All heads of the departments, of different departments of Business Administration Campus, and the teachers present in this particular meeting. Very briefly, I would like to tell you about the importance of this kind of licensing of our e-content. As you know, last more than 5 months, we are busy in online teaching learning process. Several e-contents are being developed by our own teachers and they are being provided to the students. Now this e-content, which is a creation of our team of teachers, should not be used by somebody else without acknowledging the creator, that is our teachers. We will feel proud if the e-contents created by the teachers of Modern College are being used in some other colleges, they are used in some other universities. It will be a feeling of proud for all of us, but they should acknowledge that these are the e-contents created by XYZ teacher of Modern College. For this to happen, we have to do the licensing of the e-contents created by our teachers. And when I appeal our librarian that if something like this is available, I think within few hours itself, she came with this kind of proposal that Creative Commons CC license is available. And within few minutes, teachers can create that CC license themselves, which she is going to demonstrate today. You know, we can do it for ourselves, matter of 2 to 3 minutes for getting CC license for the e-contents created by the teachers. Now, it is the era of intellectual property rights and copyrights and all that. So I think every teacher of Modern College should understand this and should know it very well, how to get CC license, Creative Commons license, for the e-contents developed by them. I wish to congratulate our librarian, Dr. Shanta Sri Sengupta, for the initiative. I wish to congratulate Dr. M.D. Alandikar, sir, our own vice principal, for the response and for organizing this kind of demo. Even personally, I am interested in proceed. There was a technical issue, but my best wishes are there and I am there. Please continue.
Okay, sir. Okay. Thank you very much, sir. Thank you for taking your time to guide our faculties. Now, without wasting much time, I request our today's resource person, Dr. Shanta Sri Madam, to kindly take us through this FGP. Over to Shantashri ma'am.
Thank you very much, Philomena madam. Very good afternoon to respected principal Dr. Rajendra Zunzar Rao sir, vice principal Dr. Milinda Alandikar sir, Philomena madam, Pratap Patil sir, Neha Dixit madam, Lolly Das madam and Vaidya madam and all the faculty members for today's faculty development program. It's a one-day faculty development program on the topic of Creative Commons license. Now, at the beginning, I would just like to tell you one thing, that please don't mix up copyright with Creative Commons license. These are two separate things, or rather two different things. But there is a bridge between it. So in today's first part, I will just explain you that, explain in brief that what is the basic concept of Creative Commons license. And then I will tell you the six different types of Creative Commons license, or in short, we call it as CC license. And then I will give you a practical demonstration. In case you people have your laptops in front of you, then when I'll be giving the demonstration, that time you can even practice it on your laptop, because it takes hardly 1 to 2 minutes for generating a license. So when I will start the demonstration, if possible for you, you can even practice it along with me in your laptops. Okay, so I will start sharing the screen. Philomena madam, is my voice completely audible?
Yes ma'am, it is audible ma'am, clear.
Okay, thank you ma'am, thank you. I will share the screen now. Okay, so as Alandikar sir also highlighted in his introduction of today's FDP session, as well as our respected principal sir also highlighted, that CC license, it is mainly, it is already existing since many years, but in this year's COVID-19 pandemic situation, CC license has come up as a burning topic in teaching faculty or in educational field. Because we all know that in order to reach out to the students, we all throughout the world, people are preparing e-contents. The e-contents, they are in the form of the video lectures, whether it is live streaming of your video lecture or the pre-recorded video lectures. They are coming up in form of PowerPoint presentations, in the form of your lecture notes, your handwritten lecture notes or typed lecture notes. In some or the other way, we are, or we have to reach to our students. But while reaching out to our students, we have to take care that our content, it should not be used by some other person with their name. Because we are working hard for the for creation of these contents, we are putting our mind, we are putting our innovative ideas. So we must look into this, that whatever contents we are sharing on the social media, even if it is on WhatsApp, even if it is on Facebook, they must bear our name, they must bear our college name. If you want, you can even add our society's name, your department name. So it not only is for the security purpose, but we all know that being in the teaching community, we have to increase our online visibility also. Because in if you just see the other part of this, during our academic promotions and all that, means in the API and all scores, it is seen, API, it gives marks to the e-contents that a teacher is developing. per module there is 10 marks or 10 points. So we have to make use of all these kind of e-contents, and we have to create e-contents. And along with that, with the help of CC license or Creative Commons license, we need to learn how to protect our resources. So first I will just give you a very brief introduction of this. Like you can see on the screen, it is open educational resources. All these e-contents, they come under the category of open educational resources once they are shared in the public platform. William and Flora Foundation, they have given a very simple example which is easily understandable of open educational resources, or it is known as OER. So what is OER? OER or open educational resources are teaching, learning and research resources that reside in the public domain. I repeat, public domain, or have been released under an intellectual property license. Like we all know, we are very much aware of the concept of IPR. IPR is the big umbrella, and under that there are 8 to 9 different types. Like copyright is one, trademark, geographical indications, that is GI, then patent is another one. So all these are the different types of rights that are under the bigger umbrella of IPR or intellectual property rights. So continuing with the definition, under an intellectual property license that permits their free use and repurposing by others. OER include full courses, course materials, modules, textbooks, streaming videos, tests, software, and any other tools, materials, or techniques used to support access to knowledge. Now moving ahead, what is basically CC license? CC license, it is actually developed by Creative Commons, and it provides the legal and technical infrastructure essential for long-term success of open educational resources. CC license, it is actually a non-profit organization based on US. And they have basically brought up this concept in order to provide protection to the open educational resources. And in the same time, these resources, they must reach out to maximum number of people. CC license, it is possible or it makes possible for the open educational resources to be widely accessible, adaptable, and interoperable, also discoverable to the community, to the educational community. And as I mentioned, that the license or the CC license can be used for website, for your blogs also. Like many teachers, they do have their own blogs wherein they communicate with the students, with their own professional colleagues. So you can even make use of CC license for licensing or for protecting your blog material, your blog articles. You can also make use of CC license for your audio recordings. Like there are some people who don't feel free to deliver online lectures, but such people prefer, or many a times we see that there are many experts who are recording their lectures, audio lectures. So even you can protect your audio lectures using CC license. I will just explain you how to make use of that. We can even make use of CC license for protecting your video lectures, offline documents, for images, presentations, data sets, etc. Now moving ahead, here on the screen you can see three symbols. The first one is copyright. We all have seen, or we all have come across this logo somewhere or the other, especially on the printed books. The second one is Creative Commons license, and the third one is public domain. Copyright, we all know that whenever we hear the word of copyright, we feel that yes, copyright is something that we should be very careful about it, and we must not prohibit, or we must not break the Copyright Act. We should always follow the Copyright Act. In India, we all are bound by Copyright Act 1957, and it was amended in 2012 along with several additions related to digital content. In this COVID-19 pandemic situation, again, Government of India, they are looking after much amendments that are required, because you all know, even if we all are looking forward into sharing the textbooks, or not only textbook, the reference books on online media, we cannot do that. There are several websites. I will take example of one website, pdfdrive.net. I think pdfdrive.net is the website. They contain full text, freely downloadable reference books, mind it, reference books. But I will request all the teachers that please don't download it, because PDF Drive is nothing but a crawler website. Whenever you are downloading that, you can, we don't read out the policies, but in the policy of PDF Drive, it is highlighted, or it is mentioned over there, that PDF Drive does not hold any sort of responsibility. In case tomorrow, because I think it is US site, I am not sure, but I think it is US site. In case tomorrow anything happens, then the person who is downloading, as well as the one who has uploaded, these two people will be responsible. PDF Drive is a crawler website. You will get whatever you want. Even we as a teacher, sometimes we feel that yes, it is our responsibility to give 100% fully downloadable contents to the students, but please don't do that. There are several ways in which we can circulate the notes, in which we can circulate these contents to the students. There are such kind of clauses mentioned in the Copyright Act. But instead of going for that, suddenly what we feel that no, we must circulate the fully downloadable contents. Please don't do that. Because Copyright Act mentions that we cannot, the books which are protected under Copyright Act, we cannot circulate these things openly. There are certain clauses, so whenever you have such queries from the students or such requests from the students, please talk to your librarian. Anjali madam, she will be able to help you out, or even you can directly approach me. I will definitely help you out. The third icon that you can see, that is the public domain. In India, typically it is said that we don't prefer going for public domain, because we are always afraid that whatever contents we have, people, they might steal our information, or people, they might put their own name in that. In foreign countries specifically, people are looking forward to sharing their contents through public domain, because knowledge, as we all know, we all are teachers, and we know that you cannot restrict knowledge. And in foreign countries, people are, that's why, moving towards public domain. In research field, it is known as open access movement. Since 2002, there was one Budapest Open Access Initiative signed, and through that, even the research work, the MPhil PhD research work, is put on open access initiative. their complete research work is put in public domain, so that people from all over the world, they will be able to go through their dissertation, through their research work, which is basically coming under gray literature category. Gray literature means not having access to these work. But in foreign countries, people are promoting the thesis and dissertations under public domain. Even in India, if you all know that Information and Library Network, Gandhinagar, they have their own electronic thesis and dissertations database of Shodh Ganga. That is a beautiful example of accessing gray literature like thesis and dissertations in public domain. Okay, so now coming back to our topic, that is CC license. You can see the logo of CC license. In a circle, there are two C's. So that is the CC license. CC license, it creates a bridge between copyright and public domain. Simple words, I will say that through CC license, you are protecting your contents and you are also giving the contents on social media or in open domain. So it basically works as a catalyst, or it basically works as a bridge. Now, as I said that in the introduction, that there are six different types of CC license. The first one is CC BY. So what is that CC BY? It is nothing but you are protecting the content and you are giving it for use, but the credit must be given to the creator. Just for example, if Philomena Madam, she has made use of CC BY license in her e-content. So what Philomena Madam is doing, that with the help of, by registering her work using CC BY license or CC BY license, she is putting her e-content in the open educational resources category. But what she wants, that whosoever makes use or whosoever refers her content, that person must give credit to madam. That person must give a citation to madam. Like if I'm using her work, I must mention a name, that Philomena Fernandez, Modern College BBA department has made use, has created this work. So this is the first type of CC license. The second one is CC BY-SA. What is that? Share alike. Here you can see it is written, this license allows reusers to distribute, remix, adapt, and build upon the material in any medium or format, so long as attributions, in simple words, it means citations or reference, is given to the creator. The license allows for commercial usage also. Commercial use means anyone who can, whom you are allowing to use your work, that person can even gain profit by using your e-content or by using your open educational resource. But the only point that is mentioned in this second type of CC license is, if you remix, adapt, or build upon the material, you must license the modified material under identical terms. Under identical terms, in the sense that, again, I will take example of same Philomena Madam. If Madam has licensed her content with CC BY-SA, and I want to reuse her e-content, I can definitely reuse it. I can definitely remix. Remix, we all know that it is, remix is a word that is made popular in film industry. Whatever I want to add, I can definitely add it. I can definitely make adaptations in it. But I must not change the license. I will have to make use of the same license which Philomena Madam makes use of, made use of in her open educational resource. Okay. The third one is CC BY-NC. What is the meaning of this NC? NC is non-commercial. In the previous one, I used the word for commercial uses, for gaining money, for getting money, for generating money, for my for generating profit also I can make use of that earlier license. But when you are making use of the third kind of license, that is CC BY-NC, that means that the creator wants you to give attribution to the creator. Also, the creator of the original e-content is making it clear that no one is allowed to make use of this e-content for generating profit or for making money. That's why you can see it on the screen that NC, it is the logo of NC is, there is a circle, and inside the circle there is a dollar symbol, and it is strike through is there. There is a cut on it. Dollar symbol means, since it is a United States organization, that's why dollar is their currency. That's why they have made use of dollar. But throughout the world, no matter which currency is used, the person is not supposed to make use of this particular e-content for commercial purposes. That is the meaning of the third kind of CC license. The fourth one is CC BY-NC-SA. You can see that the logo that is given of the license, the moment one particular word adds in the license, a symbol is getting added. So in this fourth type, what is the main meaning of the CC license? It is the creator, the original creator of the e-content, he or she wants you to give proper attribution. NC means you cannot make use of this particular e-content for making money. And the next one is SA. SA is share alike. You can adapt, you can remix, you can distribute it to n number of people. But while doing all this, you cannot change the original license that is used by the main creator of the e-content. You have to make use of the same license terms that was used by the original creator. The fifth one is CC BY-ND. ND means no derivatives or adaptations. Like you can see it on the screen, this license allows reusers to copy and distribute the material in any medium or format in unadapted form. You cannot change the original format. You have to keep it in that format itself as it is prepared by the original creator of the e-content. Along with that, BY is there. So BY means you have to give a attribution to the original creator of the work. The sixth one is CC BY-NC-ND. This license allows reusers to copy and distribute the material in any medium or format in unadapted form only for non-commercial for purposes only. Non-commercial means NC, as you can see, the license, it shows NC is written. And only so long as attribution is given to the creator. My dear colleagues, whenever you are going to make use of CC license for your work, for sharing your work, in our IR at Modern College Pune, as well as through social media, it will be, I will like to suggest you that please prefer using this particular kind of license, that is CC BY-NC-ND. It means you want the person who is going to use your work to give you attribution. In this license, through this license, you are also mentioning that no one can make use of your e-content for making money or for generating profits. Also, no one can make any sort of adaptations to your created work. So this is the particular one which I will suggest you and I will request you to make use of for protecting or for licensing your e-contents. That is CC BY-NC-ND. Now this is, I won't say it is the seventh kind, but this is the public domain dedication logo. Like you can see, this is known as CC0. It is a public dedication tool which allows the creators to give up their copyright and put their work into worldwide public domain. If you feel that whatever are your created contents, you just want to put it on public domain and you don't want any sort of attribution or any sort of reference for it, then it depends on the particular person. But I won't suggest that, I will not suggest you people to make use of this particular work for your lecture notes or for your PowerPoint presentations or for your videos. It will be better that you go for the CC BY-NC, that is non-commercial, and -ND, that is non-derivatives. So I will stop sharing the slide and I will now proceed to the second part of our session that will project on how to create CC license. Okay, Philomena, everything is okay till now?
Ma'am, everything is okay, ma'am. You can go ahead, ma'am.
Okay, thank you, ma'am, thank you. Yeah. Yes, so dear teachers, now we will proceed towards how to create Creative Commons license. So this is the website, creativecommons.org. As I mentioned, and I even showed it on the slide, that it is a non-profit organization. creativecommons.org. You can even practice it on your laptop, or you can just write it down or just watch it, because this particular meeting is getting recorded and I will be sharing the link with you later on. So this is the website of Creative Commons. First, let me show you that what sort of contents people are licensing. In this main homepage only it is there. You can see this is a music. It is some Jamendo website. It is a music website. So here you can, the font size is very small, but if you are using it on mobile, I think you will be able to increase the font size. this particular music is licensed using CC BY SA 4.0. 4.0 means at present the CC license 4.0 is used worldwide. Now this is an image. This image of a bird, it is a hummingbird. This image is also protected. But what the main person who clipped the image, he did not make use of any license. He has put it under public domain. This is one educational material. This educational material is licensed under CC BY 4.0. Now there are all these examples. Later on also you can check it out. Each and every example you can see that they are licensed using some or the other type of the CC license. So now we will go to this particular part, share your work. Once you click on share your work, just scroll down the screen and here you have to click on get started. Okay, so now there are actually two versions of this website. This is the basic version of Creative Commons website. There is another beta version. You can either work on this basic version or you can even go for this beta version. I am showing you first on the basic version. The features are same, nothing is different. The features are same. Now, the first step is license features. Allow adaptations of your work to be shared. I will request all of you to please simultaneously look into this part of the screen as well as to this part, because depending on the choices that I make here, the logo will be either added or it will be removed from this part of the screen. So the first one is allow adaptations of your work to be shared. So since I have clicked yes, so this particular CC logo will be there. No matter which license you choose, this is a CC license logo, so it will be remaining. Only here the changes will be observed. So since it is yes is clicked or yes is selected, so nothing is there. Once I click on no, now you can see this particular symbol has added. If I click on this third option, yes, as long as others share alike, another symbol has come. Like you might be remembering, while I was explaining you the types of CC license, there was a SA license, share alike. See, here you can see attribution and share alike. If it is no, then attribution and no derivatives means there will not be any adaptation of this particular work. So I will prefer for my work, I don't want any derivatives. The next part is allow commercial uses of your work. By default, it is always yes, but as I told you that we should go for CC BY NC ND. Means I don't want anyone to make use of my created work for making money. So I will go for no. So So what comes over here? Attribution, non-commercial and no derivatives. This is CC license logo. This one is attribution, means I just want whosoever is going to make use of my work, that person should give credit to me. Non-commercial means no one can make use of my creation for making money. And this logo is, there should not be any adaptations of this work. The work must be used in the same original way by anyone. Now moving ahead, please remember that just creating license is not enough. That particular work, your particular work should bear your name. Otherwise, it is sometimes seen that people, they are visiting Creative Commons website, they are generating the license, and they just forget that where have you registered your name for your work. You have just taken a license, but you need to register your work. So this is the third step. I will say this as third step because this was our first one. This is the second one. Second, first and second go hand in hand. And then this is the third one. Here you can see, help others attribute you. Because if I want someone to give my name to my creation, then that person must know my name. So help others attribute you. This is optional, but filling it out will add machine readable metadata to the suggested HTML. Like you all know that everything in the internet or world wide web, how it works. If you are registering your name to your work, then whosoever is going to make use of work, your e-content, that person will be able to know your work. Not only that, there is a Creative Commons database. Once you register the license to your particular work, then in the CC license database, your work is registered with your name. So that's why making use of this step is very much important. So just click over here. This particular part appears. This is the title of work. Okay, so title of work, for example, I will just give introduction to CC license. Attribute work to name means you have to give your name. You have to write your name. I'm typing my name and then I will mention my own designation. Simultaneously, I will request you to have keep a check on this part of the screen also. Whatever I am typing here, the fields, it is getting updated over here. So I have given my designation, then I will write down progressive education, societies, modern college of arts, science and commerce, autonomous, Shivaji Nagar, Pune, 5. Okay, everything has come over here. Attribute work to URL. What is meant by this? Like you all have attended the modern FDP as well as Progressive Education Society's faculty development program that was conducted in the month of June and July. So in that we have learned how to create our website. So if you have your website, then you can just copy paste the URL of your website. For example, I will just show you. I will copy my website address and I will paste it over here. See, this is my website address. It is even holding the moderncollege.edu.in domain name. Sourcework URL, you need not bother about that. We don't have to fill. More permissions also, you don't have to go for that. Format of the work, this is one field you have to select. Like you can see, it is mentioned multiple formats can be licensed using CC license. There is a drop box, click here. Here, what are the formats given? Audio, video, image, text, data sets. And there are there is one more, I am not able to see it on the screen over here. Basically, in this lockdown period for teaching, everyday teaching, we are either making use of the online video lectures. So when you are going to make use of CC license for protecting your online video lectures, then that time you have to select video over here. Then if there is some audio lecture, you have to go for using this particular format, selecting this particular format audio. If it is the image, then you have to select image. If it is just a text, like you want your lecture notes, you want to contribute your lecture notes for the institutional repository, that should be typed lecture notes. We don't accept handwritten lecture notes because it doesn't look good also sometimes. And since it is on a website, on institutional repository website, so we request our faculty members to please go for typed lecture notes. That also you can protect it. That time you have to select text over here. Then here the license mark, don't do anything over here. Let it be like this only. Just for example, if there is any content which is not any content of yours which is not on online platform, but you want to license that particular content, then that time here you have to go for license mark and select offline. Offline means this content is not available online, but you are going to make use of this content, this license for the offline document. So now I have created license. Here you can see the image has come of the license and the complete matter has also come. Now I will show you the example that if you want to protect your PowerPoint presentation, how you can do that. Just copy this particular image by right clicking on the image. I will show it again. Take your cursor on the image, right click, copy image. Now this is just a blank slide. Paste the particular image. See, it has come. You can just increase the, for demonstration basis, I'm increasing the size. So it has come here. And along with this particular image, you need to copy the matter also that was appearing over here. Select it, Control C. Selected Control C and
दादू धनके देईल आता चांगली आई छोटी.
मीना मैडम म्यूट करा माइक. मीना मैम
या सो आई हैव कॉपीड द इंफॉर्मेशन फ्रॉम द सीसी वेबसाइट एंड आई विल पेस्ट इट ओवर हियर. सी दिस हैज कम. Here you can see the license, the image of the license as well as the complete matter is there. Introduction to CC license by my name, my designation, Progressive Education Societies, Modern College of Arts, Science and Commerce, complete college name is licensed under a Creative Commons Attribution - Non-Commercial, No Derivatives International License. So it has come. Now, what you can do when you are going to make use of this particular license for protecting your PowerPoint presentations, just copy this particular section and paste it on each slide. Here the font size is big. You can just decrease the font size and you can make use of this on each and every slide. I will just show you the example. Just remember that it should be readable because you are going to share it. So 14 font size will be more than enough for it. Just copy this part. And you can paste it over here. See, this has come. You just need to align it properly. Here, I have not done the alignment. So, in this way, in each and every slide, just don't make use of the CC license on your main slide only. You need to make use of the CC license on all your slides. Just adjust it properly, do the proper alignment, and at the footer of the slide, you can make use of the license part. Okay. So now, if I want to make use of this particular CC license for protecting my lecture notes, the same way you have to do, copy it, copy the image. Now this is just a blank document, but in case anything is written over here, go for the footer section. So this is here. I will just paste the CC license logo. Here you can see I will delete all this part and along with that we need to, as I told you, we need to copy this particular license statement also, because why copy and pasting this particular statement is important, because any lay person should be able to understand what is written here. you as a creator will definitely know that your particular work is protected under what sort of license. But anyone, you are not protecting it only for yourself. Even you want the person who is going to use your work, that person should also know that he is prohibited from what sort of things. He is not allowed to use this particular work for generating money. He is not allowed to adapt, make any sort of adaptations of this particular work. So in this, for this reason only, along with this image, you need to copy paste the statements also. Okay, so this is done. This is for the Word file. But I will request you, if whenever you are circulating your lecture notes, please don't go for only Word format. Just convert it in Office 10. You can directly do it from here only. Just save it. In PDF, just save it in PDF format. And I'll just show you that how it looks in PDF. See, this is how it will look. Here also, while making use of CC license for protecting your lecture notes, like we did it in PowerPoint presentation, please copy paste or make use of this particular section in each and every page. Since I have selected the footer option, so it will automatically appear. That's why I have told you that go for the footer section option. Because in footer, once you select footer section option, then you need not remember copy pasting it. It will automatically appear in each and every page of your document. Now here you can see this section is appearing in blue color, and there is a link. Now when I am moving the cursor, my website address is coming, my personal website address is coming. This shows that this particular work is licensed to me. If I click over here, it redirects to my particular website, my personal website. Okay, what I've done, I have just clicked over here and it redirected to my personal website. In the same way, I will just show you one thing. Coming back to the way of generating CC license. If I remove my website from here, I have removed my website, okay? I remove my website from here. Nothing will change. I'll just see what happens. The same thing, since it was already registered, that's why it is again redirecting you to my personal website. I will show you another example over here. I'll just change the topic. BBA test lecture. I will not use anything over here. Or just wait, I will give some other name. Here again, text it is there. License, I will not change. I will still make use of the same license. Attribution, non-commercial and no derivatives. Now, what I will do? Copy it. After copying, I will just paste it over here. I will go back to my CC license website and I will copy the statement, CC license statement. Okay, this has come. BBA test lecture by Dr. Sengupta SS, librarian, and rest of the details. Now what I will do, I will save it in PDF again. And we will see how it looks now. Yeah. So this has come. BBA test lecture by A. Now here, the difference I would like you to notice, in the previous document, when I was moving the cursor, since there I had made use of my website address, so it was showing my website address on the screen, and once I clicked on this link, it was redirecting us to my website. But in this second example, when you are moving the cursor on this part, here you can see the Creative Commons website. I will just click on this link. Now see what happens. After clicking on this link, hello ma'am, the screen is visible?
Yes ma'am, screen is visible ma'am.
Yeah.
Yes ma'am, screen is visible.
Okay,
you can see ma'am.
Okay, you can see the Creative Commons website?
Yes, yes, we can see.
Yeah, so what has happened, now we are redirected to Creative Commons website, and here the person who is going to make use of my e-content, that person will be able to know that it is protected under what sort of license. Attribution, non-commercial and no derivatives. So that's why please make it or please note this thing, that even if you are making use of this same license, CC, BY, NC and ND for all your work, just don't copy paste it. For each and every work, for each and every individual work of yours, you have to do this step. You have to repeat this step of registration. It should not be like ki kisi ko nahi samajh mein aayega ki just copy paste kar lenge. It is not like that. You have to register each and every e-content of yours on this particular CC license website, because as I mentioned, each and every data gets updated on the CC license database. So that's why it is very important, and it hardly takes a minute. since today I was explaining you and I was showing you all these things. So that's why it took time. Otherwise, it takes hardly a minute to generate a license. Now, for protecting your video lectures, in the same way you can make use of CC license. Like here, you have generated the license, you have registered your work, and this particular license statement has already been copied by you. While delivering your daily lecture, I will just request that at the beginning of your lecture, you can just share a screen with the students. Start recording your lectures, because in our IR, through our institutional repository, we also accept your daily video lectures. No matter you are not using any blackboard or any whiteboard, but still we can reach out to the students. And in this period, when the students are not able to come and meet you personally, this will be really beneficial. Because anytime the students, they can just access the institutional repository and they can check out that for this topic, which all points was covered by the teacher. So it will be very much useful if you start recording your daily lectures, and before starting your actual lecture, once you start recording, just share a slide. Mention your name. For example, Professor Pratap Patil, then he's from which department? Progressive Education Societies, Modern College, full name of the college. And along with that, the name of the topic, whichever topic sir is going to teach, for example, C programming or any topic. I'm just giving one example. Whichever topic is today you are going to teach, prepare a slide of that, and at the end of the slide, copy paste this license image and the license term. Keep it for a minute and then stop sharing your screen, and you can continue with the regular way of delivering your lectures. Once your lecture is over, stop the recording, and then you can just upload that video on YouTube, because here in our campus, 2 to 3 teachers, they have already done it. Some many more teachers, they are now sending me their videos lectures in the same way. I will just request Pratap sir, I will stop sharing the screen now. From my side, I will request Pratap sir to share his screen.
Yes, ma'am.
Hello. Is it visible, ma'am? Hello.
Yes, yes, sir.
Disturb, sir.
Okay.
We can see.
Yeah, so Pratap sir, can you just start playing just mute the video and start playing.
Okay.
Mute the video. Because sometimes some disturbance comes. Just pause it. Now here on the screen, you can just see this is the video lecture that was shared by Professor Mrs. Pooja Paratne of our mathematics department. So what Paratne madam she did, she made use of the slide, like I was just telling you, she was making use of the slide. And
others
are please requested to mute their mics, please. Yeah, so as I was telling, here on the screen you can see that Paratne madam, she has prepared a slide, and in on the top, the name of the title of the topic that she is going to teach that day, she has written it, her name, then the designation, college name, department name, everything is there. And at the end of the slide, the CC license image and the license statement appears. Pratap sir, just play it again.
Yes, ma'am.
The slide appears for just a minute, almost a minute max, and then madam has stopped sharing that screen, and then she starts her regular lecture. This is just a way to make the person aware, to make any viewer aware that these video lectures are protected under CC's license. Okay, sir, you can stop it now.
Okay.
Stop playing it. Yeah.
Yes.
So, like this, you can, I think you can just, you were able to understand that how even for recording your daily lectures, you can make use of CC license. I will just mention another point, that for protecting the pre-recorded lectures, like there might be some cases ki hamare paas pehle hai, hamare lectures already recorded hai, and you have even uploaded them on YouTube. So how to protect them? एक बार अगर YouTube में आपने already upload किया है, definitely you cannot insert anything inside that. But what you can do, create a license. Create license in the same way like we are doing. Copy paste that license term. Don't copy the image. In this, for this particular example, don't copy the image. Just copy the license term. And what you need to do, license term in the sense that license statement, 3 to 4 lines of license statement. And in YouTube, when you are uploading your video, a description part comes. In that description part, just copy paste those 3 to 4 lines. In that way, you can even protect your those videos which are already uploaded on your YouTube channel. Is it clear? I will just repeat. Agar aapko aapke pehle se jo videos aapne upload kar liye hai already, and if you feel that wo public domain mein hai, and you want to protect them, so generate a CC license and don't copy the CC license image. Just copy those 3 to 4 lines of license statement and paste it on the description part of YouTube video and save it. In this way, you can license your pre-existing videos on YouTube. If another example or another form of e-content is audio lectures. ऑडियो लेक्चर मतलब आप उसको रिकॉर्डिंग करने वाले हो आइदर ऑन योर मोबाइल और एनी डिवाइस दैट यू हैव. एट द बिगिनिंग ऑफ ऑडियो लेक्चर पहले आप रजिस्टर कर लो आपका वो ऑडियो लेक्चर. जस्ट रजिस्टर योर ऑडियो लेक्चर ऑन द सीसी लाइसेंस वेबसाइट एंड यू नीड टू स्पीक आउट. आपका ऑडियो लेक्चर शुरू करने से पहले आपसे बोलो फॉर एग्जाम्पल गुड मॉर्निंग आई एम डॉक्टर शांतिश्री संगुप्ता लाइब्रेरियन प्रोग्रेसिव एजुकेशन सोसाइटी मॉडर्न कॉलेज ऑटोनोमस शिवाजी नगर पुणे 5. टूडेज टॉपिक ऑफ लेक्चर इज इंट्रोडक्शन टू आईसीटी एंड दिस पर्टिकुलर वर्क इज प्रोटेक्टेड अंडर. देन यू नीड टू स्पीक दोज फोर लाइन्स. Then you continue with your lecture. So in this way, you can protect your audio lectures also using CC license. So I have given you the demonstration of how you can generate CC license. What are the different types of CC license? There are basically 6 types. But I will again repeat, please try to make use of CC BY NC that is non-commercial and ND that is non-derivative. That will be the best thing that we need to add, that we need to make use of for protecting our e-contents. Okay, so that was done, and then how to make use of the CC license for protecting your PowerPoint slides. Even by creating a slide, you can share it before starting your video lecture. Then your regular lecture notes, कोई इमेज भी अगर है, कोई फोटोग्राफ है, वो फोटोग्राफ भी आप definitely you can license that particular photograph using CC license. So I am done from my side. Philomena ma'am, the session is open for queries. If you have any doubt,
yes, ma'am.
Let it be simple. Please get it cleared. No problem.
Okay, ma'am. Faculties, anybody has got any queries, doubts, y'all can kindly ask.
Yes, thank you, Philomena ma'am. Good afternoon, Dr. Shantashree Sengupta madam. This is Lolly Das from the Department of BBA.
Good afternoon, ma'am.
Regarding format of work, if we click on the drop-down box, other than audio, video, image, and text, can you please explain what is data set and interactive format?
Madam, data sets, actually, even I have not used any time. And I don't think even we are going to make use of that data set. Because basically, okay. We are making use of only the image, text, video, and audio formats. And interactive format also, it is not much used by our community. Till now, I have not heard that the teaching community people, they are making use of interactive formats for protecting their or making use of CC license. In case I come across any example, then I will definitely share it with you.
Sure, ma'am. Not a problem at all.
Okay.
Ma'am, yes. One more question. Ma'am, regarding attributing work to URL, that is giving our website URL,
yeah.
What if someone doesn't have their personal website created? So it can be left blank. It is not a required, right?
No. It is not required. I showed you the second example, that BBA test ka jo main example dikhaya tha, in that
yes.
I did not mention my website address.
Right.
So what was happening whenever someone was clicking on that link, okay, on your document, you are copy pasting that statement, license statement. So whenever someone was clicking on that link, it was getting redirected to CC license website.
Okay.
So in that, the person was going to become aware that what all rights are given by the creator to the person who is going to use it.
Right.
So it is not compulsory to give your website address. you can, but it is really, I would like to suggest that at least please mention your name and your affiliation. Means okay. Your designation, your department name, your college name. And the title of the work is very much required.
Right.
Urmila ma'am has put a question on the chat box.
Just a second, so, I will check it.
Yeah.
Instead of putting CC license in description of the video, is it okay to put it in thumbnail? Since thumbnail can be changed easily for existing YouTube videos. Madam, Urmila madam, if it is, you are going to upload it on thumbnail, like I think thumbnail, it just appears like if you are sharing a YouTube video link, then it appears over there as a thumbnail. It is nowhere existing in the actual your video. Okay, it is not existing in your actual session. So how many people they are actually looking into the thumbnail part?
Okay, fine, no problem.
Yeah, you can definitely make use it in the thumbnail, but along with that, it will be better that you copy paste it even it in the description section, because description section people at least look into that. But thumbnail, once you start playing the video, it nowhere appears, na? It is just for promotion part.
Yes,
so
okay,
that's
no
why
problem.
You make use it in the thumbnail part also. If you want, but in the description part, it will be very good because it always remains in the description part.
Okay, no problem. Yeah.
Okay, ma'am, okay.
Thank you.
Welcome, ma'am.
Yeah, Neha Dixit, ma'am, Dr. Neha Dixit, ma'am has asked whether we can put it on the footer. I think that
yeah,
is possible.
Yeah, she had explained that.
Yes. So yeah, anywhere it can be put. Yes. I think, ma'am, teachers will have doubts when we really start working on it, you know. When we really start implementing, putting this license copy on our e-content, that's the time when we may get our doubts. And definitely we will get in touch with you, ma'am.
Definitely, ma'am. I have shared my email address also on the chat box. Whenever you are going to send me any mail, or if you want to contribute for the institutional repository, like Principal Sir and Alandikar Sir also mentioned, I would like to request you that in an Excel file or in Word also, you can just create a table. You need to mention the class for which you want. You are contributing the particular e-content, then the topic of the e-content.
Okay.
I will mention it on the chat box itself. Topic of the e-content, then subject or paper, anything you can mention. And you can just send me the YouTube video link. I have shared it on the chat box. The class, for example, for FYBBIB, if someone is going to contribute for FYBBIB, then you need to mention FYBBIB, the topic of the e-content, the subject or paper name. If you want, you can even mention the course code and the YouTube video link. Because in our IR, I don't upload the video as it is. I just upload the YouTube video link. And the student, they can reach out through it, gets redirected to your own YouTube channel. So in case any such faculty member is there who is not having his or her own YouTube channel, please do create it. And through your Modern College email address only you please go, because it provides us unlimited space. Normally, normal Gmail account, it gives us only 15 GB. And we all know that our so many mails are there. Really speaking, we don't get much space in our normal Gmail address. But please use the college mail address. Through that, you create your own YouTube channel. and just upload it. And while sending me, you can send me the YouTube video link. I need these four details, and mail me on librarian@moderncollegepune.edu.in. You can reach out to me anytime. I will even share my mobile number. This is my WhatsApp number also. So anytime you have any doubt, either mail me, you can call me, you can WhatsApp me. I am always available. And I would love to talk to you people and help you out regarding any problem for creating CC license.
Okay, madam. Yes, ma'am. So we are done with it, ma'am?
Yes, from my side it is done.
Okay, ma'am. Any teachers have got any doubts? Nothing, right? Now, since ma'am has shared her number and email ID, probably we can get in touch with her as and when we face any trouble. So now I would like to propose the vote of thanks. So first of all, I would like to thank our principal, sir, forever encouraging the teaching faculty to update ourselves to the latest changes that has been taking place. I think this kind of teaching learning happens only in modern college. So I'm very grateful for being a part of this college, and I'm very proud to be a part of this college, and same with all the faculties over here. I also like to thank our vice principal, sir, Dr. Alandika, sir, for always supporting us to learn new things. In fact, 2-3 days back when I went and spoke to sir about it, sir said, anytime you can just conduct it. You know, any new learning is always welcome. So I thank our vice principal, sir, for the same. I thank our today's resource person, Dr. Shantashri Sengupta, ma'am, for taking so much of trouble and taking so much of time to explain each and everything in detail. When I actually met ma'am a week ago, ma'am asked me, what is the mode of teaching you're using? And I was just worried, like, what is the mode? I was just wondering, maybe it is ma'am is asking me, you know, PPTs and other e-content. So I told, you know, there are the various ways of teaching. Sometimes it is the PPTs, sometimes it is the oral lecture, sometimes it is a whiteboard teaching. And ma'am said, okay, it's fine. You can have a CC license done for any mode of teaching. And I got relaxed and I felt that this knowledge should be shared with all the faculties, and requested ma'am if she could take a session for all of us. And ma'am willingly agreed. Having done this earlier, though we all of us could not join, ma'am said, you just tell me the timings and date and I'm ready to teach everyone. So we are so grateful for you, ma'am, for explaining us so elaborately and in detail, and even sharing your valuable time with us. So thank you very much, ma'am.
Thank you very much, madam. It was a pleasure for me, and I'm really very much thankful to Principal Sir, Alandikar Sir, and all the wonderful faculty members of your campus. Thank you very much.
Yes. Thank you, ma'am. Thank you once again.
I will be sharing the video. I will be uploading it on YouTube and I will sharing it. And while uploading, I will be even adding a CC license to it. So it will be very much clear to you all that how we can make use of CC license for licensing our videos. Like whatever I explained you today, the same steps I am going to make use of for licensing our this particular session also.
Yes, ma'am. All right, ma'am.
Okay. Thanks a lot.
Thank you, ma'am. Thank you so much.
Wish you all a happy weekend.
Thank you. Same with you.
Thank you so much. Yes, ma'am.
Okay. Thank you, sir. Thank you. Okay.
Yeah.